Thank you. Well, Philly, here we go again. You spoke and we heard you. Very delighted to be here. And today's announcement, I just want to remind everybody, it's being streamed on NLL TV. And let me start off by thanking everyone of those at home watching or in their offices watching. You should be working, not watching, but watch us anyway. And thank you for all of this great crowd here today. It's absolutely fantastic to see so many friends and business partners and family members. Just a great, great moment to be here. It's really amazing. Thank you, Mayor Kenny, for joining us today. It's always great to bring a box lacrosse team to a city whose mayor played box lacrosse. So I just learned that, and it's fantastic to have you here. It's an amazing thing to see what a great crowd we have. I want to recognize a few folks, and if I miss anybody, I apologize, but my good friend Don Smolinski's in the crowd from the Eagles, and thanks for the Eagles being here and supporting us. Really appreciate your presence. JM and Simon from Translux, a big partner of ours, thanks for being here, guys. And Vince Milano from Sprix, really appreciate you celebrating with us. In building anything made to last, you really have to understand your past and respect its impact on the future. So I want to take a moment to recognize a very special person. Michael French is here. He's the current owner of the New England Black Wolves. And Mike's a former player in our league, believe it or not, and also the former owner of the Philadelphia Wings. So many great memories here, and I want to great legacy of lacrosse in Philadelphia, and we're bringing it back. And thanks for your leadership, your membership on our board, and we couldn't do it without you, so I wanted to recognize you. I want to thank Dave Scott. Thanks, absolutely. I want to thank Dave Scott and his team of extremely professional executives. Since I arrived in Philly over 10 years ago, feels like 10 years ago, you guys welcomed me, and you've been incredible partners in everything we've done. And we've done a lot of business over the years together, and I'm just absolutely honored and ecstatic that we get to do it again. And really excited about that. I couldn't imagine scripting a better couple of owners that we just announced, one in San Diego, and now we're announcing here in this great city. And I have to say that the process working with Dave and his team was extraordinary. True, true professionals. We're so excited that the league office is located here now, and we have a team of our own coming here real soon. I want to also thank my staff, and particularly Dave Rowan, who really did an amazing job working with Sean Filger. Dave's our COO. Sean's the COO here. And I really appreciate you guys doing an amazing job together and just working really hard to make sure all the needs were met so that Comcast Spectacor can make an informed decision and a smart decision. And we think you made a great decision. So thank you. Going into our 32nd season, there's no doubt that the NLL is growing. We've created a significant amount of momentum over the last 18 months with major changes and major announcements. There's several reasons for this, but the biggest is the great people we have and the great people that we're surrounded by. It's been a tremendous year for us, from launching our own over-the-top digital streaming platform, and many of you are watching on NLL TV today, over 25,000 subscribers to that platform, and we're not even a year old yet. We are gaining upwards of 350,000 viewers on our Twitter Game of the Week, and we only produced half a season of Twitter games. Really excited about that. People actually really, really watch us in large scale, and another great reason for this partnership, because it's no secret, Comcast Spectacor and its parent company is a leader in sports programming, and we're excited and looking forward to tapping into your knowledge and expertise in that area. Part of the 5-year strategic and with the right owners in the right markets and a sharp focus on quality ownership, we're going to become a large league, and this is our time to do that. Comcast Spectacor represents really the embodiment of what you look for in a great owner. A few weeks ago, we announced San Diego and Joe Tsai's ownership of our new expansion team in San Diego, and it was thrilling to welcome such a renowned and respected businessman. And now, only a few weeks later, we're here making another great announcement in this amazing East Coast city, the city of brotherly love in our home, in my home. So really excited about that, and we're super fortunate and honored that Comcast Spectacor is being added to the list of our ownership. Returning NLL to Philadelphia is supremely important. It's the home of the league office, as I mentioned earlier, and it helps us in accomplishing another initiative in our strategic plan, increasing our awareness as a league, greater relevance in the U.S., and of course having a flagship team here in a major U.S. city. There's a rich tradition here, and there's many former players in the crowd, and I could see some lacrossers that have come here to join us, and there's an amazing tradition here. And we know that this is an amazing sports town, and the environment that's going to be created here around the team's games is going to be renowned throughout the league. We're excited to bring the best lacrosse players in the world. It wasn't known to me when I first became commissioner that we are the top league in our space. We have the best players in the world that do amazing things on the floor, and I couldn't believe it. I'm an ex-soccer guy turned lacrosse commissioner, and I've fallen in love with this sport. It's dynamic, it's fast, it's electric, it's thrilling. You've got to watch the replays multiple times in order to understand what the players even did. It's really, really exciting sport, and we're so excited to bring you here to Philly. So now, to make it official, because there's been a lot of rumors for years, and we're here to celebrate Philadelphia coming in. It's my distinct honor and pleasure to award the City of Philadelphia and Comcast Spectacor the National Lacrosse League's 11th franchise. Please join me in welcoming Dave Scott, President and CEO of Comcast Spectacor.
First, I just want to thank Vic and really the league for coming out in force today and all of you. This is certainly an exciting day for all of us. When Nick called me first and kind of presented the opportunity for this expansion franchise and a chance to bring lacrosse back to Philly, I probably had two things that I really thought through. One was Nick, who I got to know pretty well since he first came to Philly. I think we came about the same time. You know, I might have been a little ahead of you. But anyway, the vision he has for this league in terms of thing was really the success of the other owners. I think as people know, there's three other NHL owners that have lacrosse franchises. Got Calgary, Buffalo, and Colorado. We know those guys well. And they've done a great job in their markets, well received in the communities. It's been good for the business. So that was certainly a big one. Comcast Spectacor, as you guys all know, we've got a long history of sports, primarily here in Philadelphia. And you're going to hear a lot this morning about the plans for the 18-19 season. Might sound like a long way off, but if you're part of the planning process, the blocks are all being put in place and a lot more to do, so. And lastly, I just really want to thank all of our fans. We couldn't do this without you, and I want you to know I'm personally committed to investing in this franchise. We're going to invest for the long term. We're going to build a great team, a winning team, something we can all be proud of. So again, very exciting. Just to finish off and introduce the mayor, as you guys all know, I think Philadelphia probably has the reputation of being the greatest sports town in the world, best sports fans, and we're honored today to really have our biggest fan with us. I couldn't be happier. So with that, it's my pleasure to introduce the mayor of Philadelphia, Mayor Jim Kenney.
Good morning, everyone. And when Ike Rich would call me to tell me that we were getting a lacrosse franchise again, I jumped out of my seat. He said, could you come down and help us announce it? I said, I'll change my schedule, do whatever I have to do. I mean, I remember watching the Flyers when they first came into the league, and we were in the Spectrum, and there were very few people there because no one really understood what it was, and it started to build. And across such a natural offshoot of hockey, I remember Dougie Fabel playing for the Wings, and it's just an exciting sport. It's terrific to have here. The other important thing is really, really important that people are in these suites, in the concession stands, working the changeover crews, the sound people, everybody will have additional days to work, which is always critically important for our city. So I just think it's phenomenal, and it's just such a thrill to see it come back. I know there's going to be a contest for naming the team. I like the Wings, I'm just going to tell you right now. I'm a Wings fan. So good luck with the naming, but thank you so much for bringing the sport back to Philadelphia. It's a natural for Philadelphia. It's fast, it's hard-hitting, it's tough, and it represents a lot of what we like to watch in the world of sports. So congratulations and welcome home. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So we've had a lot of people working on this project, and I really want to recognize the one that really has worked most with the league to help us get out of the gates and really bring this to life. I mean, it's amazing. 12-month plan. It's amazing what we've done in a short period of time and still have a lot to do. But with no further ado, let me introduce our new governor of the Philadelphia lacrosse team, Sean Tilger.
So excited. I want to start by thanking everyone at the league and at Comcast Spectacor that worked tirelessly to put this together. Especially Nick and his team, the direction the league is going, the momentum that the sport is gaining. This is the perfect time for us to launch the franchise. I also want to thank the alumni here, the Philadelphia Wings, Mike French. It's the tradition you guys have created here is what really grew the fan base originally. We've shown we can sell out buildings, and you guys, we met last week with the alumni, their passion is so, it just spills over everybody. It's they're gonna be key to this whole process, and thanks. Most importantly to the fans, as an organization, we're committed to growing the sport. Paul will talk more about it, but it's gonna start from a grassroots level. We got a year before we'll actually. Our main goal is going to be to deliver a fan-first experience. The team we put in place are their owners, not renters, and they're passionate about the sport, and they're passionate about making sure that it's the best experience in National Lacrosse League. The sport itself, for those of you who haven't been to a game, you're part of the event. It's like, it's fast, it's hard-hitting, it's like going to a concert during a sporting event. It's the best way to explain it. When we sat down and figured out we were going to launch the franchise, the first thing we knew we needed to do was find the right leadership in terms of who's going to run the lacrosse operations, who's going to run the business operations, and then we found two true pros. It's my pleasure to introduce them. It's Sean Newton and Lindsay Massiangelo. Sean's a former professional lacrosse player, former All-American lacrosse player at North Carolina, and he's been embedded in the grassroots community for lacrosse for the last 10 years. Lindsay Massiangelo has worked in sports for at least 15 years, and worked with me. She's former vice president of marketing for the Philadelphia Flyers, and very well known in the market, truly gets what it means to make the fans first. With that, I'd like to introduce Sean.
Great, thank you, Sean. I can't believe I'm standing here today on the floor of the Wells Fargo Center, where I grew up watching professional lacrosse. It was those games in this building that inspired me to pick up a stick and begin my career as a young fifth grader over at the Portstown Rec Department. From there, I was fortunate enough to go on and become a professional lacrosse player. And now, to be operating a team in the city that's so close to my hometown is a dream come true. There's never been a better time for the city of Philadelphia to have a professional indoor team. The growth of sport has been incredible. There has never been more kids playing than there are today. It's not only the kids playing, but the type of talent this area is producing. This past year, the NCAA Player of the Year is a Philadelphia native. This is our time, Philly. As we look to grow this sport, there are so many things we're going to do in this community. We'll hit on that with our players and how they're going to be involved. It's so important to give back to this community that's going to give so much to this team. We have a huge grassroots approach that we're going to be incorporating in the next coming year as we look to build this team. As we prepare for the 2018-2019 inaugural season, we have three goals in mind. We want to be competitive, we want to be entertaining, and we want to be highly visible in this community. You are the fans that are going to help build this organization, and we look forward to involving you guys as much as possible during this process. There's a lot of exciting things happening in this city, and Philadelphia lacrosse is one of them. As we build this organization, we're going to be bringing the best lacrosse players in the world into this building on a nightly basis. This is our team in Philadelphia. This is all of our team. We're going to build this to be the best organization in the NLL, and that's going to start with you and this great leadership. Now, to talk about the business side of things, it's my pleasure to introduce Lindsay Massiangelo, our Executive Director of Business Operations. Thank you.
Hey, I'll be short of the speakers here. Thanks, Sean. Appreciate that. As Sean said, we are building a team that represents the grit of our city and the passion of our fans. And we will match the lacrosse community and help continue to grow the sport. We are looking for promotional partners that will help us reconnect to the fans that are already out there and grow the sport to fans who may need to be introduced. And we'll look for strong business partners that will help elevate the experience people have when they come to a lacrosse game at the Wells Fargo Center. Our vision for this team is to create an affordable experience that will fit for individuals and groups of all sizes. And most importantly, fun is a priority. Fans can get involved now by visiting our website, phillylax2018.com. By becoming a season ticket member now, you'll be able to get priority access to the best seats in the building. You can also follow us socially at phillylax18. We want to continue to pump out content and share all the things that are going on around this team and give exclusive access to our fans. So please follow and like us and tell your friends to do so we can continue to spread the word about lacrosse in Philadelphia. Now the question that we've all wanted to hear, Mayor Kenny sort of introduced it for us, right? What is the name of this team going to be? Well, you are all going to tell us. After this, our Name the Team contest will be launched on that same website, phillylax2018.com. We are asking fans to submit names. We'll take the top names and then push them out into a poll for fans to vote. We do believe that this is our team, the team of the city. So our fans will ultimately decide the name of the team. So we look forward to hearing from all of you and for the passionate fans out there. So please spread the word and submit your names. In just a moment, I'm going to ask all the speakers to join me up here for a photo op. Anyone who has any questions individually for speakers, we will take those to the side of the stage after the presentation. Thank you all for being here.